Hello, I am Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic, and today I want to explore an important mystery. Why photos from mobile phones sometimes look brighter and more interesting than those from cameras? The reason is simple. High-end mobile phones can automatically work with HDR, or high dynamic range, and bright areas in the photos really shine. But cameras can do it too, just not many people experiment with that. So, let's try it with Canon R50 V and shooting into HDR PQ. But let's quickly add that, of course, any camera can do it and anybody can experiment with this. This video might look complicated, but the main messages are actually simple and important. First, the new high-quality displays are redefining the way photos are displayed. And it's just a shame not to experiment with higher dynamic range. So if you are watching this video on a high-end display and YouTube uses HDR, everything will shine, much more than normal photos. Second, mobiles can generally do this magic better, but cameras can do it too. You just need special settings, which I'll show you with the example of the Canon R50 V and shooting into HDR PQ. But thirdly, nothing special is actually needed, because we just need RAWs to do the magic. Which is perhaps the most important point of all. Forget all those complicated concepts, just find the RAWs in your archive, open them in Lightroom and start playing with the world of HDR. We can start here. The real world is full of colors and huge dynamic range. Normally, we would be living just in 8-bit world and SDR monitors. Once we turn either to RAWs or at least to 10-bit heaves, we suddenly enter the new world, which has much bigger dynamic range and it's much more interesting when viewed on HDR monitor. If you own Canon, do find that setting and turn on HDR PQ. And suddenly you are capturing haves or heaves. And once you download Digital Photo Professional, it's a free piece of software from Canon, you are able to very quickly enter the world of HDR because you are able to work with heaves, you are able to edit them. And suddenly you see that the lights are really shining much more. And what I can guarantee to you that once you enter the world of HDR in your still photography, it'll be very hard to go back. At the same time, there are many catches. Of course, the biggest simple catch is that if you want to really enjoy the HDR, you need a high-end display. So please do try to watch this on your high-end mobile phone or a television which is capable of HDR. The abbreviation HDR might sound familiar to you. For many years, we have that function HDR, the old-fashioned HDR, which is used for things like that, that it does 3 or 5 shots, then it combines it. Yes, this is the old-fashioned HDR, but it's a very different world. It's not the HDR we are covering here today. Well, forget it. Today we are playing with the real thing, with the real HDR. It means photos which have really the huge differences between lights, which are capable of displaying lights and shadows and even things like this. And I do indeed hope that if you watch these shots that you like them. I have to admit, when I was testing this on some older displays, older computers, older televisions, there might be some issues, but still I decided to take the risk and show you all this, because again, once you enter HDR world, it's very hard to go back. You do not need Canon camera, you do not need Digital Photo Professional software. The quickest way how to play with this is just to open RAWs from any camera and use Lightroom, as I do here. That is a traditional histogram. Once I activate HDR, we got that extra space, extra wide dynamic range. And once I start editing the shot, look at this. I simply move from here to here. And suddenly, amazing things will start happening. And I know I repeat myself, but once you do it, it's very, very hard to go back. This is my favorite example. I went to this religious event in the mountains of Moravia, and this is the original photo. This is a slightly edited one. And once I've seen it, I realized how amazing it is. Because if you are a photographer, you know that it's very hard to capture things like this because there's a lot of contrasts, a lot of shadows, a lot of light. But the HDR is really able to cover it. So it's just amazing. In Lightroom, you're able to export it. You can't save it as HEVs, but you can try TIFFs, as I did here, and you use 16 bits version here. The catch is that once you export this in TIFF, you'll get a really big, big files. But it's still worth doing that. And I really fell in love with all this technology here when I was playing with old RAWs from my trip to Tuscany. It was the Canon R50, which is really quite nice camera, by the way. And I just had some RAWs. I edited them in Lightroom and I was just really amazed. Again, I have to admit that I was really overdoing it. I wouldn't typically be editing it to that extent, but I just wanted you to see what you are able to do. This is, that would roughly be the view of your normal JPEG, and that is how amazing look you are able to get out of the HDR versions of the shots from RAWs. And you might be asking, why should I be doing that? Why should I be playing with these HDR things? And that is the answer. Because if you are at least a little bit experienced with video editing, you suddenly realize that you are able to use HDR libraries, you are able to edit photos, use these amazingly shining photos for your videos. And suddenly you'll be, I promise, tempted to dive into your old RAWs and editing them into video. And now I suggest we see some examples. We've already seen this. For me, as I mentioned, that was one of the really eye-opening experiments when I realized that, oh, I just don't want to go back to old-fashioned JPEGs or the SD versions of the shots, because a lot of light, a lot of whites, a really complex situation. And even here, again, I really do hope you watch this on a good display, because these shots are really amazing. I suspect if you are on some older display, it might look terrible, but if you have a good option, good television, good mobile phone, you'll be just amazed. And not by the shots, they are not that exciting, but by the technical possibilities we suddenly have. Because before that, you had simply no chance to capture shots like that. Sun, sheep, mountains, sunsets, amazing light, complicated light, and suddenly you have HDR options. You are able to capture things which you were able to capture it, but you were not able to display it and to send it to your friends and or share it with your viewers on YouTube, as I do right now. So amazing new worlds are awaiting us. Here are some more low profile shots, boring shots, but again, you can see how it all works, and that typically you would enjoy the HDR effect on shots like that. You have a lot of green, sort of light, then there is the sky, and well, dark in the shadow. Forget about white dark in the shadows in a normal SD world. Some more examples, flowers, and all these shots are shot into HEVs. We already mentioned it at the beginning. These are not RAWs, but I slightly edited them because I'm working on MacBook Pro, and it's so tempting to use it to its maximum capacity. So you have to be careful, but typically if I would be really editing this for a real usage, not for demonstrations like here, I would probably not overdo it like I did here, but still it's amazing. And I apologize, I'm stressing it once more. If you have the option to see this on a really good display, you'll be amazed what new worlds are you able to enter. Beautiful corners of mountains and some more boring corners of garden. Again, a lot of light, a lot of shadows, a lot of bright colors, and sleeping dog. And finally, a couple of examples of more or less boring photos and train. Again, edited shots and not edited shots, different versions. Again, I remember when I was testing this on some older displays, I had some issues, so I apologize if you see some of these shots in bad colors. I see them in perfect shape, but unfortunately, and it should be stressed, it should be mentioned, the HDR world, HDR videos are generally uncharted area where there might be some issues with compatibility, some colors, color spaces. I just do not want to go into details, but I spent really a lot of time before recording that video. But I just wanted to start with that because, again, I do indeed believe that this is amazing revolution we are facing right now. Sun is setting, sheep is beautifully illuminated, rest is in the shadow, but it's still there and it's amazing shot. If you ask me, can I do the same thing with videos? And the reply, of course, is yes, indeed. You can do it. At the Canon R50, we are again able to activate shooting into HDR PQ. And then you can also set some advanced movie recording formats like you can see here. And as I mentioned, I decided not to cover video because it's, again, very complex, very complicated. And I believe that the covering still photography is essential for many of us who just want to open new worlds. But what I'm doing right now, as you can see, there are some examples of video I recorded with the Canon R50 V. And again, they are in the HDR world, so it's really, really interesting. So thank you so much for your attention. I hope I gave you some inspiration. Take care. I am Jan from Prague, the Czech Republic.